Yeah, what's up, guys? Sean here, aka ImaFlyNmidget. Dudes, I'm making this video today. I've been stoked to make this video for a while. We are going to be comparing some of the biggest car vehicle games in Roblox, and we're gonna see which one's actually the best. So I'm really excited for this because, you know, a lot of people are always like, oh, it's a vehicle simulator and ultimate driving debate, and yes, those are the two biggest which we will be comparing, but I'm also throwing in a little bit of a wild card of Accelerate just to see how it compares. We're gonna be grading them off a scale I've kind of got. We're gonna be rating each one on each topic 1 to 5. We're gonna see which one comes out on top, so let's freaking do it. Dudes, before we get into today's video, though, I want you to leave me a comment down below. Are you guys hashtag Vehicle Simulator, Ultimate Driving, or Accelerate? Let me know down there. That's going to be mainly a popularity contest down there of which one has more players. In the video, we're going to actually be going over specific topics in each one and see which one's actually better. Oh, and another thing, I am getting rid of the face cam today because I want you guys to focus on the game itself. Okay, so each game is going to be rated on 6 different categories, all right? We're going to be going over car looks, car's drivability, the garage, the map, things to do in the game, and ultimately, how often updates are coming into the game. Each category will be rated 1 to 5, 1 being the worst, 5 being the best. Okay, let's get started. Now, we are obviously using the 4GT in the games to give a little bit of cohesiveness between the three, but we're starting out with car looks. So, this car is actually pretty good. The pros that we got is the car looks super clean, it's super detailed, it's super unique. I do want to point out that one really nice thing with Accelerate is the fact that you can put your spoiler up and down, and it looks really, really, really clean. Not to mention the doors flip up and down as well, giving a really well-rounded experience. The cars also have turn signals and hazards. The downside to these cars that I'm not super fond of is the fact that you can't really turn your lights off, and the lights actually don't show up on the car. In other games, these lights would actually show on and off, and in here, it doesn't really show a difference. That's a very minute detail, though, and overall, these cars look amazing in this game and are definitely incredibly detailed. So with that in mind, I'm giving the looks rating of this game and these cars a solid 4 out of 5. Coming over to Ultimate Driving, the cars in this game are absolutely gorgeous. They are absolutely gorgeous. Ultimate Driving cars have pretty much everything you will ever need. It's got turn signals, it's got hazards, it can even move the spoiler up and down on this car as well, which is really nice, and I think just a really cool addition. The lights in the car actually go on and off and keeps the LEDs on, which I think are wicked sick as well. I think the cars in this are definitely just amazing to look at. They might not have doors that open up, but I think that everything you need in an actual driving game is 100% satisfied with these absolutely gorgeous cars. With that in mind, Ultimate Driving does get a 5 out of 5 stars when it comes to the looks of the vehicle, just because I just cannot get over how amazing they look in this game. Coming into Vehicle Simulator, when it comes down to vehicle looks, it does look pretty good. I cannot say it doesn't look bad. However, there aren't any good features on it like the other games have. I mean, yes, it's got some headlights, and it's got a few things here and there, but there's no spoiler that comes up, and there's no doors that open, and it really just kind of looks actually not super amazing compared to the other games. However, I do have to say that the sound on this thing is amazing. The sound in Vehicle Simulator on their cars is hands down the best out of all the other games. So I didn't factor in sound in the other games, but I felt like Vehicle Simulator had to have sound factored in because, one, the car doesn't really look all that great compared to the other games. Let's be completely honest. The car doesn't look amazing. However, the sound is definitely top-notch in comparison to the other games. With that in mind, it definitely is the worst-looking car out of the other two games, but it still doesn't look bad, and again, the sound is amazing. So I'm gonna have to give it a 4 out of 5 stars because it is still a really cool looking car and cool sounding car to drive. Next up, we're talking about car drivability. Now, the cars in Accelerate are really great. They're well-rounded. This is a new game, but the cars feel really strong. They feel very strong, and the handbrake is really fun to use because it is on the space bar. However, I will say some cars spin out like this and are a little bit buggy, so sometimes it's a little bit of a toss-up when you're going to drivability in this game. Another few downsides include the fact that there aren't really any nitrous in this game yet. Not sure sure if it's something that's going to get added in at a later date, but it's not really added in just yet, making the car driving experience not super fun, but definitely not bad. In light of that, I am going to give Accelerate a solid 3 out of 5 stars when it comes to drivability, because it is fun, but ultimately not the best. The driving in Ultimate Driving is super fun. You can go super fast without having your car actually explode. The drifting functionality is a little tough to learn, but it is really fun to use once you're good at. Plus, there's a manual mode, which I would never be able to ever use. It's ridiculously hard to use, but it's really cool if you really want to fine-tune your driving skills in Roblox. One thing that is a little bit of a con is you do get stuck a little bit too often in this game, in my opinion, so the drivability is sometimes a little bit too hard to deal with. But again, you can do so many cool things driving in this car, and there's even a cruise control, which is, I think, the only game in Roblox that does have cruise control. It allows you to really just relax and go the exact same speed, which is really cool as well. So in light of all this, I am going to be giving it a 4 out of 5 stars. Now, when it comes to drivability in Vehicle Simulator, it's definitely the most popular preferred game because, really, it's just crazy. There's so much going on, and you can go over any curb and jump things and do insane stuff, and your car is really just a tank. Hands down, this game is the most fun when it comes to drifting because of the variability you can do with your tires and because of how much fun it is on different surfaces. So, the drifting in this game is definitely one of its pros. However, some cons do include the fact that your car just is so unreliable. You never know when it's just going to absolutely just get destroyed and just go absolutely insane. In addition, Vehicle Simulator doesn't have all the bells and whistles like the other games when it comes to drivability, like manual mode or anything that's kind of fun. But again, the drifting in this and the amount of air you can get on jumps is ridiculously fun. Plus, I can't help but mention the fact that you can get some insane air in this game and actually control your car when it's in the air, which is actually pretty sick. With all that in mind, I'm going to have to give this a 4 out of 5 stars because, again, it's solid, but definitely could have some improvements. Next up is going to be the garage functionality. Now, in Accelerate, it is pretty cool. It did get a little bit of an update, and it is really nice in terms of customization. However, just keep in mind that this is still very, 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 very new. Some pros about this is the fact that you can actually customize each individual piece on your car, which is wicked insane. However, that is also a little bit of a con because it takes ridiculously long just to paint your entire car a single color. But you could change things like transparency, reflectance, material, wraps, and ultimately the color of the car. So it's pretty sweet. However, there are no ways to improve the performance or how your car actually looks outside of the original body. In light of that, I am going to give Accelerate a 3 out of 5 stars here because I do really like the fact that you can customize specific parts of your car. However, it does take very long to paint the entire thing, and it's definitely just not all there yet. When it comes to the garage in Ultimate Driving, it's not terrible. However, there are a lot of things that could be improved on. For example, the biggest bummer of them all is the fact that you have to buy a game pass to do a lot of different customization with your cars. But it is nice that you can actually change the color of your car, you can change the license plate, you can add some boost, secondary color, rims, and window tint. There's the necessities there, but nothing too crazy. You can't get the craziest looking cars in this game because, again, it is going for a realistic feel. With that being said, again, it's not terrible and it definitely has the necessities that you want, so I'm gonna go ahead and give it a 3 out of 5 stars because, again, it is solid, but there are some things that can make it a lot better. The garage function in Vehicle Simulator is hands down the best. You can customize pretty much anything you want in this. Now, you can't do it piece by piece like in Accelerate, but you can do rims, you can do spoiler, you can do neons, window tint, headlights, and the best part about it is it definitely has the most modifications for the way your car actually drives, which is really cool, with engine, braking, nitro, turbo, all sorts of great stuff, the suspension, how your car rides. I mean, there's so much customization you can do with this shop. It's literally insane. Plus, they've got the really cool custom wraps on the looks and everything. So there are no cons with this besides the fact that you aren't able to actually customize piece by piece on your car, but I think that that is definitely okay, and in light of that, we are definitely giving the garage and Vehicle Simulator a 5 out of 5 stars. Next up is going to be the map. So starting us out in Accelerate, the map is actually really cool. You've got yourself a little bit of a cartoony feel to the game, whereas the other two are very realistic looking. This is more of a cartoony feel, and the map is actually really massive. It's so big, there's so much you can do in here, and the game isn't even done yet. So some cons to the map are the fact that obviously the map is not fully done yet, and there are still improvements that need to be done. But the developers are taking a step in the right direction as the map is massive and does feature some really cool things. Plus, because it is so massive, this is one of my favorite things you can do in the game, is the fact that you can actually select a location and it'll actually give you a route to get there. Overall, because of all these things, I am going to be giving the map a 3 out of 5 stars because I think it is off to a really great start and has a really cool theme to it, but it's obviously just not done yet and there needs to be some more improvements. When it comes to the actual map and ultimate driving, it is absolutely insane. It's so insane that there has to be separate Roblox games to actually see the entire map because it doesn't all fit in one game. It's absolutely unreal and the map is super detailed. It actually feels like this is real life. So hands down, I'm going to have to give the map in Ultimate Driving a 5 out of 5 stars because it is hands down the biggest and most detailed map out of all the games. The map in Vehicle Simulator is actually an interesting topic because it is very cool and it is really awesome. The detail isn't necessarily there like in Ultimate Driving and the uniqueness isn't really there in Accelerate, but I will say the thing about the map that is really cool is that there are a lot of Easter eggs and a lot of secrets within this map. Tons of secrets, tons of Easter eggs, and a lot of just really cool spots that a lot of people just like to hang out in. It's also a very clean looking map that is very easy to navigate and get around in, so that's definitely a plus as well. I'm gonna have to give this a 5 out of 5 stars because of all the super cool Easter eggs and all the really cool things that are hidden around the map and the fact that it's just a super clean map. So I'm gonna have to give it a 5 out of 5 stars, which puts Vehicle Simulator in a pretty good spot. Next category is the fact that are there things to do in the game? In Accelerate, there are not really a ton of things to do. There aren't a whole lot of different classes you can do or different type of role playing you can do. Again, it is still a very new game. There are some firefighting type things you can do and some police and stuff like that. But again, it is a very new game and there isn't a ton to do. One thing I will point out that is very cool is the fact that there is a leveling system in this game. So the more you drive, the higher you level up and the better cars you can actually get. This game isn't just focused on getting money when you're driving. You can't just buy a bunch of Robux and get the coolest car in the game. You actually have to be driving a ton and leveling yourself up to actually unlock those higher level cars. Unfortunately, since I just don't think there is a ton to do in this game just yet besides actually just drive, I am going to be giving it a 2 out of 5 stars. When it comes to things to do in Ultimate Driving, there are a plethora of things to do. For example, there is a leveling system down here. The more you drive, the higher you level up. And the thing that's even better than that is the fact that each job has a different leveling system. So you can go ahead and do a completely different thing in the game and level up a completely different way. This game has all the goodies when it comes to role playing, and you can really just keep doing endless amounts of things. Plus, it even just got a new racing feature recently, which allows you to race all along the map and makes it really, really, really fun. So in terms of things to do in this game, I have to give it a 5 out of 5 stars because there's really just so many things you can do. I still haven't done everything in this game and I've been playing it for months and months and months. Things to do in Vehicle Simulator. Well, I will say that this has actually improved a lot over the past year or so, but the racing in this game is definitely top notch. There's lots of different races, lots of different strategies you can kind of use to do that. There's obviously the police kind of station and you can be a cop and do some cops and robbers types thing. There's also apartments that they added in where you can actually build your own apartment, which is wicked cool. There's a lot of unique things that you can kind of do in this, not to mention the soccer dome over there, which is really cool as well. So the game might not have a whole lot of role-playing features to do in it, but it does have lots you can do, not to mention different vehicles. Like, you can actually fly planes, you can go ahead and drive jet skis and boats and all sorts of things, and the Rocket League kind of style of the game is wicked cool as well. So there are tons of things to do in this game that I have to give it a 5 out of 5 stars, even though it's very different than the other games. And the last category is going to be how frequent are the updates, because ultimately I think the more updates a game has, the more fun it actually is and the better it is at actually keeping players, because people always want to try new things. So I think it's a big portion of the game. Starting us out with Accelerate, this game actually gets a fairly large update at least once a month. There was an update on 7/11 and there was also an update on 8/25, and I'm assuming there's going to be another update in the next week or two, and these are fairly big updates. So in light of that, and it is a new game and I think there's only one developer actually working on it and not necessarily a team, I am going to be giving this game a 4 out of 5 stars when it comes to updates. When it comes to Ultimate Driving in terms of game updates, it actually does vary a little bit. So it used to be in the past where this game didn't get a ton of different updates, but lately this game has been fire hot with updates. There's been some major updates being dropped week after week, and the game has really seen some serious improvement. Now, considering the past this game's had, and the fact that it hasn't always just had amazing updates coming out week after week after week, and I do understand that that is very, very, very hard to do, this game is going to get a 4 out of 5 stars when it comes to updates, because right now it is fire hot with updates. There have been so many awesome updates coming to the game, but it hasn't always been like that in its entire lifespan, which is totally understandable, but a 4 out of 5 stars I think is a reasonable price to pay. And lastly, when it comes to Vehicle Simulator and updates, it is a little bit of a bummer because Vehicle Simulator used to be a game that was updated super frequently. There was new cars, new additions, new things to do in the game weekly almost. I mean, there were updates all the time that made it super fun and everyone was so hyped up. This game was constantly front page, always one of the biggest games on Roblox and was definitely so much fun. Those were the good old days, but unfortunately, lately, there hasn't really been a big update in a really long time. There hasn't been new cars like they said there would be. There hasn't been new features. There hasn't really been a whole lot. And I do want to say that when they have been releasing updates lately, they've been so buggy and so unplayable that the game has just really been hard to play for a lot of players. And in all honesty, I think the updates in this game is going to be the bane to its existence. It is a really great game, and I know that the developers spend a lot of time on it and spend a lot of time really just making the game awesome. But I do have to give a lower rating when it comes down to updates in this game. Like I said, the past, it was so good. And I know the developers really care about this game and they're really trying. I totally get that. The sounds are awesome. There's certain things in the game that are definitely awesome and I do really appreciate it. But unfortunately, the updates in this game have been lacking. There's been months without some really cool stuff. And unfortunately, that's just really bad. So I do want to give it a 1 out of 5 stars, but I can't do that because, again, the game was really solid in the past, had some really cool updates, really did some great things. So I am going to give it a 2 out of 5 stars, which is still very low on the scale. I do understand that. But again, the game has not seen any updates in a really long time, and it could just be just releasing a car or something very simple, but the game really just hasn't seen anything, and it's been a real bummer lately. So I hope new things are coming to this game in terms of the updates, but unfortunately, I am going to have to give it a 2 out of 5 stars when it comes to updates. That brings the grand total of Accelerate up to 19 out of 30 stars. I didn't have high hopes for this game because it is a very new game, and it's a newcomer on the block, but I definitely wanted to show a comparison with this game in comparison to the two big ones. So I think 19 out of 30 is actually not a bad score, and I'm excited to see where this game is in a few months. Vehicle Simulator does come in with a whopping 25 out of 30 stars, which is still very, 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 very good. However, it is not necessarily the best game out of the three. Barely. It was such a close race, but see what I did there? Pun with the race. But Vehicle Simulator is a great game. 25 out of 30 is still a really good score. Ultimate Driving there comes in at a whopping 26 out of 30 stars. Kudos, Ultimate Driving. This is one of the best games on Roblox. Anyways, guys, that is going to do it for the video for today. Hopefully, you guys did enjoy it. This was very fun for me to make. I want to do more videos like this where I compare different type of simulator games or role-playing type games or other sources of games on Roblox. I think it is really cool to kind of see there's so many games that are so similar, but which one's actually the better one? Again, congratulations to Ultimate Driving for being the best car game, in my opinion. Again, this is all subjective. This is all based on my opinion. Everyone's opinions are different, but I felt like the categories were pretty fair. The ratings were pretty fair based on what we had in the game, but again, let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. I love to hear guys' feedback. Which game do you think is actually better? I do appreciate Ultimate Driving, Vehicle Simulator, and Accelerate for their hard work, and the games are actually really sick. So they're all pretty sick. Check them all out in the description, guys. But again, that is going to do it for today. Let me know if you agree with me or not. Smash a like on the video. And until next time, guys, if you haven't already, make sure you be fly and subscribe.
Okay, yeah, I'm a flyer. Hit a clip and hit a spit a killin' with the rhythm spillin' up the building, chillin' about to make a killin' villain, always spillin', about to stack it to the ceiling. Haters over there, we're not aware of ya. Rockin' with my boy Shawnee, a character. Rep the red, white, and blue, America.